After completing 10th class, there is a lot of options that surface in front of you. You can choose to study higher education like intermediate, which is also called PUC or 12th, or you can do diploma. You choose the option which best suits you to reach your life ambition. If your ultimate goal to settle in life as early as possible, there is an option that could make you settle quicker than the others. It is the ITI. ITI stands for Industrial Training Institute. The main objective of the ITI is to make a normal person like you into skilled manpower who is ready to be employed in a factory. The need for these industrial training institutes came into existence after the Industrial Revolution at the world level. Since then, the industrial training institutes started existing. The Industrial Revolution over the period had brought in a new technique called the production line. It replaced the previous practice of one person creating one product. Since then, production increased and the cost of production reduced. For such a particular job, the factories or the industry started recruiting a person with basic technical skills to perform the given work. To the needs of the industries, the industrial training institutes or technological institutes as being called in other countries had established. There, the willing candidates will be given training on their related work in the factory. During the training period, they will be familiar with the work they should do in a factory and the techniques required to do the job efficiently. The rules and regulations provided for their welfare and conduct will explain. It is necessary to avoid exploitation by the firms and also to tackle misbehavior from the workers. In India, these industrial training institutes came into existence probably during the World War times to meet the British needs. After the 1950s, industrial training institutes are established at the national level. At present, there are 14,886 ITIs in the country in various states. Among them, 3,159 are government ITIs, and the remaining 11,727 are private ITIs. This count may increase from time to time based on the ambitions of the governments. At present, the Directorate General of Training is the apex body under the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. It develops policies, implements them and coordinates with the ITIs at the national level. The role of the DGT is to make policies regarding vocational training. For example, the norms for ITIs, NSTIs and so on. The DGT implements its policies. It coordinates and develops training schemes such as Craftsman Training Scheme for ITI students, Craft Instructor Training Scheme for NSTI students, and the Apprenticeship Training Scheme for apprentices, and so on. There are some other central government organizations that are working in coordination with the DGT. They are, the NCVT or the National Council for Vocational Training. It functions as a board for ITIs. Next, the CSTARI or the Central Staff Training and Research Institute in Kolkata. It is the body that publishes the syllabus for all the trades in ITIs as well as NSTIs. The link is in the description below. Check it once. The NIMI or the National Instructional Media Institute in Chennai provides the printed material for all the trades in ITIs. The books prepared by the NIMI are standard for ITI students. You can buy the books online. The link is in the description below. Check it once. If you observe, the central government bodies working at the national level. But the ITIs are under the ambit of the state governments. The state governments decide the establishment of an ITI. It is the sole discretion of the state governments to give training on a particular trade depending on the local demands. The state governments are the ones that initiate the admission process and conducts the exams at the ground level. The state governments implement the guidelines issued by the DGT and do the ground level work. Now the question comes, how to join? The admission procedure is carried out by the state governments. First, they release a notification for admission and receives applications. Then, they announce a date for counseling. Applied candidates should appear for the counseling along with their original certificates. Your seat will be confirmed during the counseling based on the merit in your 10th class. Some state governments mandate the fitness certificate for giving admission. You should note that the admission procedure may be different from state to state. ITIs cumulatively, throughout the country giving training in 75 engineering trades, 60 non-engineering trades and 5 trades for the visually impaired. The duration of the main trades is 12 months are 1 year, 24 months are 2 years. Few trades duration is less than a year and more than a year. Here, trade means a particular job operation on which a person will be trained. For example, mechanic diesel, mechanic motor vehicle, electrician, fitter, and so on. During the training period, you will be trained in a particular trade. After completing the training, you have to write an exam. The name of the exam is All India Trade Test. At present, it is conducted online through computer-based test mode. If you pass the exam, you will get the certificate. Now, what are the options you have? Probably, you may apply for an apprenticeship or directly get employment, that is the job. The link for applying for an apprenticeship is in the description. Check it out if you want. If not both, you can use your skills and become self-reliant and be your own boss. Apart from these, there are some states that are allowing two-year trade trainees to study for a diploma or a degree through the bridge course. I hope this information is helpful to you. Now lastly, I want to guide you to the resources. I mean, the study material for ITIs. The study material is prepared by a central government body called the NIMI in Chennai. Its full form is National Instructional Media Institute. You can buy all your trade-related books from this website. The link is in the description, go and check it out. There is another website called Bharat Skills. It is helpful for ITI students. The online content for all the trades is on this website. It includes the PDF copies of the trade theory, trade practical and even the question banks also. Please remember this website. The link is in the description, go and check it out. It is also available as an app in the Play Store. You can install it. Thanks a lot for staying up to here. If you feel it is helpful, please share it and like it. Mention your opinion in the comments section, and please subscribe to the channel to encourage me to create more content like this.